And this is Miles's ECG, which again, as you probably already heard, is completely normal and again shows a very normal QT interval and none of the changes we would associate with long QT syndrome.
Boston Children's has a reputation in cardiac electrophysiology for children which surpasses anywhere else in the country. It's been led for many years with great skill and great dexterity, and we have huge experience. And when you're dealing with these conditions, experience means an awful lot. And I'm sure that's why people want to come to Boston. My name is Dominic Abrams. I'm a cardiologist and electrophysiologist here at Boston Children's Hospital. And my specific role is to work in the inherited cardiac arrhythmia program. I was recruited from London, where I worked in a very similar role, but in a slightly different role than I worked in both adult and pediatric cardiology. So I was dual trained in both specialties, which meant I could look after people of all age groups. And that, of course, becomes very helpful when you're dealing with families and inherited heart disease. We will see patients who've come in following the tragic sudden death of a family member, people who've been picked up incidentally, or people who've been diagnosed following symptoms. And we'll then try and get as much background information as we can. We look at the first degree family relatives first, so the parents, the siblings. And essentially we work out, we draw a big family tree and we keep going and we keep going. And often from one 10-year-old having their appendix out, you can unearth a whole inherited arrhythmic condition across a family. It's always incredibly traumatic after someone has died suddenly in the family to have to come back to hospital in the first instance. So we try and get as much information as we can ahead of time, getting any reports we need, getting clinical information on the family. And so when the family come to see us, we've got all the information we need. We keep the clinic as coordinated and as organized for them as possible. So we're very much basing all our investigations on the history that you provide us with, and also the electrocardiograms that we've recorded both at rest, when you stand up, and during exercise. Often they come to us with not a lot of information. What they've seen on the internet may have scared them a significant degree. And often it's great just to be able to sit down, talk them through it, explain it exactly what the condition is. And seeing patients leave, seeing them empowered, seeing them as part of the process of their ongoing care is very satisfying. It is often a detective game. I mean, we may start with nothing and you have to piece things together, and that's the reason why we need to understand the family. Because there may be one subtle clue in one family member that gives the whole game away, and then you can really work out what's going on. In my experience, all families want to know is why did it happen and what can we do to prevent it happening again. And if you can give them some answers, that's really what they want to hear.